Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد Dear brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I have great pleasure in teaching you this new book of mine, Nurun al-Nur, in this DVD. This book contains 12 ayat from Surat al-Nur, starting from ayah 35 of this surah. As in my other books, I concentrate mainly on the lexical and grammatical aspects of the ayat, explaining them wherever needed in detail, inshallah. I'll read the first ayah and explain to you and translate it to you and then explain the grammatical and lexical aspects of this ayah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allahu nuru as-samawati wal-ard. Mathalu nurihi kamishkatin fiha misbah. Al-misbahu fi zujaja. Az-zujajatu ka'annaha kawkabun durriyun yuqadu min shajaratin mubarakatin zaytunatin la sharqiyatin wala gharbiyyah. يكاد زيتها يضيء ولو لم تمسسه نار نور على نور يهدي الله لنوره من يشاء ويضرب الله الأمثال للناس والله بكل شيء عليم. Now Allah نور السماوات والأرض. Allah is the light of the heavens and the earth. Light in the sense of guidance. Allah, grammatically, Allah is مبتدأ. Nur samawati wal ard. Nur is khabar As-samawati is mudaf ilayh, wal-ard is ma'tuf. Now in certain countries like India and Pakistan, they have a different way of expressing mudaf and mudaf ilayh. They say Allahu mubtada nur as-samawati. Nur is mudaf, as-samawati al-mudaf ilayh. Al-mudaf and mudaf ilayh both constitute the khabar. This is not right, because Nurun, Nuru is a independent word. So that is the khabar, and Samawati is mudafili. Both of them cannot be the khabar, because if both of them are the khabar, so what to do with the rafa' of Nuru? Nurun, Nurun is marfu'. Why is it marfu'? It is marfu' because it is the khabar. So Allah nuru samawati wal ard, mathalu nurihi kamishkatin. The likeness of the parable of its light is like a mishka. Mishka is a niche, N-I-C-H-E. Which is a hollow in a wall wherein a lamp is placed. In ancient days it was like that. مَثَلُ نُورِهِ كَمِشْكَاتٍ فِيهَا مِصْبَاحٌ. In this niche there is a light, lamp. مِصْبَاحٌ is اسْمُ الْآلَة, like miftah. فِيهَا مِصْبَاحٌ فِيهَا مِصْبَاحٌ. Now, the i'rab of this ayah, or this part of the ayah, Allah nuru samawati wal ard, mathalu nurihi, mathalu is mubtada, nurihi is mudaf ilayh, kamishkatin, as you know, kamishkatin is a shibu jumla, kamishkatin fiha misbah. Fiha misbah is jumla ismiyah. It is a na'at of mishkah. Kamishkatin fiha misbah. Now there is a, with regard to the spelling of words in the mushaf, of course, as you know, the spelling of the mushaf differs from the spelling, the orthography of modern Arabic. As you can see, the word al-samawat, al-samawat, after the meme there is an alif, small alif. After the waw also there is a small alif. Now this small alif which is placed above a letter or after a letter is called al-alif al-khanjariya. Al-alif al-khanjariya. Al-khanjar means dagger. And it looks like a dagger, a small dagger, because on top of it is thick and it tapers down. So it looks like a dagger. So it is called Al-Alif Al-Khanjariyatu. Al-Alif is feminine. Al-Alif Al-Khanjariya. So please note that after, in the word As-Samawat, the Alif Al-Khanjariya is placed after the waw, As-Samawat. After the meem and after the waw. Now in the next line, kamishkatin. Please note that here the alif al-khanjariya is placed right above the waw. Right above the waw. So the rule is that if the alif al-khanjariya is placed above a letter, right above the letter, only the alif has to be pronounced and the waw has to be omitted. Any letter above which it has been placed is to be omitted. Here, kamishkatin, the alif al-khanjariya is placed right above the waw. So the waw has to be omitted. But in as-samawati, the alif is placed after the waw. So you have to pronounce the waw as well as the alif. So please note that, it's a very important rule of orthography. I'll read it again. Allahu nuru samawati wal ard, Masalu Nurihi Kamishkatin is like a niche, fiha misbah, in which there is a lamp. Al misbahu fi zujajatin, the lamp is in a glass chimney. The word zujaj means glass, the sheet of glass is zujaj. As in material, as a material it is zujajun. It is ismul jins al jam'i, ismul jins al jam'i. Now, glass zujajun is uncountable. So if the ismul jins al jam'i is countable, then the singular with ta means a. For example, samakun, fish in plural. Samakatun is one fish. Tufahun is apples. Tufahatun is one apple. Tamrun, dates, one date is tamratun. But with uncountable nouns, like zujaj, it means the singular with ta means a piece of. So zujajun is glass, zujajatun a piece of glass. It is also applied to glass, a thing made of glass, like a glass of water, glass, and also a chimney. There are other words like jubnun. Jubnun is cheese, jubnatun is a piece of cheese. And zubdun is butter, and zubdatun is a small piece of butter, or a portion of butter. Khashabun is of wood, and khashabatun is a piece of wood. So we must make note of that. If it's countable, then a fish, a date, an apple, but it is uncountable, it means a piece of. Zujajatun, a piece of glass, khashabatun, a piece of wood, and jubnatun, a piece of cheese. Al-misbahu fi zujajatin, the misbah, the lamp, is in a glass casing. Al-zujajatu ka'annaha kawkabun durriyun yuqadu min shajaratin mubarakah. Az-zujaja, this chimney, ka'annaha, as you know, ka'anna is a sister of inna. So ka'anna, ha is the ism of ka'anna, it is mansub. Here it is dhamir nasb, fi mahalli nasb. Kawkabun is the khabar of ka'anna, it is marfu. Ka'annaha kawkabun. Kawkabun is a star. Ka'annaha kawkabun durriyun. Durriyun is the ya here is ya'un nasab. As we say, deenun, religion, deeniyun, religious. Tarikhun, history, tarikhiyun, historical. The same way, durrun is a pearl. Durratun is one small pearl. But durrun is pearls, plural. Durriyun, pearly, looking like a pearl, shining like a pearl. Ka'annaha kawkabun durriyun, as if it is a pearly star. A star shining like a pearl. Yuqadu min shajaratin. Yuqadu is the majhul of awqada. Awqada is bab 4. Awqada is to kindle a fire. So awqada yuqidu. Passive voice yuqadu. It is lit. Now the dhamir mustatir, which is a naib fa'il of yuqadu, refers to al-misbah, the lamp. This lamp is lit min shajaratin. Again, shajara, as we have just mentioned, is ismul jins al-jam'i, shajarun, trees, shajaratun, one tree. Min shajaratin. Mubarakatin. Mubarakatin, blessed. This is Bab 3rd. Baraka, Yubariku. Masdar is Mubarakatun. Ismul Fa'il is Mubarakun. Ismul Maf'ul Mubarakun. Feminine Mubarakatun. Min Shajaratin Mubarakatin. Zaytunatin. Zaytuna is also Ismul Jins al Jam'i. Zaytunun is olive. And Zaytunatun is one olive. But here, Zaytun also is applied to the olive tree. So here it means olive tree. Min shajaratin mubaraka. The lamp is lit using the oil of a tree, of a blessed tree. Zaytuna is badal. Shajaratin mubarakatin, zaytunatin, is an olive tree. La sharqiyatin wala gharbiya. Again, sharqiyun is ya, here is ya al-nasab. Sharqun is east, sharqiyun is eastern. Gharbun is west, gharbiyun, western. And the ta is for feminine. La sharqiyatin wala gharbiyatin is an adjective, naat of shajara. Shajaratin mubarakatin, la sharqiyya wala, neither eastern nor western. Now what does it mean, neither eastern nor western? The Mufassirun have explained that it means that the tree, this particular tree, is in a plain, is growing in a plain, which is not in an orchard. In an orchard, it is surrounded by other trees, so it gets very limited light, sunlight. But here it is neither eastern nor western. It doesn't grow either in the east of the orchard nor in the west of the orchard. It is independent, and so it gets the sunlight all through the day. La sharqiyatin wala gharbiyatin, and that helps it to helps the olive to ripen perfectly. Zaytun la sharqiyatin wala gharbiyya, neither eastern nor western. Yakadu zaytuha yudhi'u walau lam tamsasu nar. Yakadu zaytuha, zayt is oil. Zaytuha, the ha refers to zaytuna. Its oil almost burns. As you know the word kada. Kada is one of the sisters of Kana. It takes ism and khabar. Yeah, here Kada Zaytuha. Zayt is its ism, and the vowel sentence yudhi'u is its khabar. Yakadu Zaytuha yudhi'u. Its oil almost catches fire. Adha'a is Bab 4. Allah yudhi'u idha'atum. Walau lam tamsashu nar. Even when no fire touches it. Walau lam tamsashu nar. Massa ya massu. Massa is ea group. That is sami'a yasma'u. Sami'a yasma'u. Masistu. First person singular in the past tense is masistu. I touched. Massa. Massa is for masisa. So yamassu al mudara. Walau lam tamsashu lam is a jazim. So walau lam tamsashu narun. Al ha in tamsashu refers to the zayt, oil. Narun is walau lam tamsashu narun is feminine, that is why it is law lam tamsashu tamsas. Walau, even if for example uhdhur al ikhtibara walau kunta maridan, uhdhur al ikhtibara walau kunta maridan. attend the examination even if you are sick. There is another example in the book. لن أقبل هذه السيارة لن أقبل هذه السيارة ولو أعطيتنيها مجانا. I will not accept this car even if you give it to me, even if you were to give it to me free. ولو أعطيتنيها مجانا. So here يكاد زيتها يضيء ولو لم تمسسه نار is a element of exaggeration. يكاد زيتها يضيء ولو لم تمسسه نار ولو لم تمسسه نار. Now when with reference to the Quran, the meaning is that the meaning of Allah, the Quran, meaning of the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they speak to humanity, they speak to the reader even without the intermediacy of explanatory notes, tafsir, even without tafsir or explanation. So many people have found guidance from the Quran just by reading the Quran, just by reading the Quran, and they did not know tafsir, they did not know explanation of the meanings of the words, but even without these explanatory notes, they were able to find the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's like this. وَلَوْ لَمْ تَمْسَسْهُ نَارٌ نُورٌ عَلَى نُورٌ. I have a line of poetry. I will write it on the black whiteboard and explain it to you. It also contains the word كَادَ يَكَادُ. دان مصفٌ فويق الأرض حيدبه دان مصف فويق الأرض هيدبه يكاد يدفعه يكاد يدفعه من قام بالراح دان مصف فويق الأرض هيدبه دان مصف فويق الأرض هيدبه يكاد يدفعه من قام بالراحي. Now the poet is explaining, a pre-Islamic poetry, and the poet is explaining clouds which have come down very close to the earth. He says danin, the mubtada is haydabuhu. Mubtada is haydabuhu. Haydab is its fringes, the fringes of the clouds. Haydab. Haydabuhu. The ha refers to clouds. Haydabuhu danin. Danin is ismul fa'il from dana yadnu. Dana yadnu, to come close, to come near. Dana yadnu. Ismul fa'il is danin. Like masha yamshi, ismul fa'il mashin. Dana yadnu, danin. With alif lam ad-dani. We say ad-dani wal qasi. Al qasi means one who is far away. Ad-dani is one who is near. Ha, Adani wal Qasi, يَعْرِفُهُ الدَّانِي وَالْقَاسِي. This is a fact which every one knows, whether he is close to us or far away. دَانٍ. So دَنَا يَدْنُو دَانٍ. اسم التفضيل is أَدْنَا. أَدْنَا closer. The verb is دَنَا يَدْنُو. أمر is أُدْنُو. أُدْنُو مِنِّي. Come closer to me. أُدْنُو مِنِّي. دَانٍ. So this is خَبَر. And the ya has been omitted. Daniyun, actually it was daniyun, like mashiyun, like qadiyun. So danin musiffun. Musiffun is a small file from bab 4, asaffa yusiffu, also means to come close. Danin musiffun. Haydabuhu danin musiffun. Its fringes are very close to earth. Fuwayqa al-ardi. Fawqa. Fuwayqa. Fuwayqa is tazghir. Tazghir of fawqa. A little above. Now this is, I wanted to say, it is exaggeration, an element of exaggeration. Danin musifun fuwayqa al-ardi. Yes, we say bu'ayda al-salati. Kharajtu min al-masjidi bu'ayda al-salati. I left the mosque a little after the salah. قبيل الأذاني ذهبت إلى المسجد قبيل الأذاني. I went to the mosque a little before the أذان. So فويقة and قبيل بعيدة, all these are تصغير forms. داني مصف فويق الأرض. الأرض is مضاف إليه, as you know. Haydabu. Haydabu is mubtada. Haydabuhu danin musiffun fuwayqa al-ardi. Three akhbar. Khabar. Haydabuhu danin musiffun and fuwayqa al-ardi, just above the earth. Yakadu yadfa'uhu man qama bil-rahi. Now the ism kana, kada is man qama, man. Man ism al-mawsool, qama is صلة الموصول. من قام يكاد من قام يدفعه. دفع is to push. دفع يدفع. فتح يفتح, like فتح يفتح. دفع يدفع. It also means to pay. دفعته مثلا أجرته. I paid his wages. أو أجره أو أجرته. دفع يدفع. يكاد من قام يدفعه بالراحي. That is one who stands up. من قام. One who stands up can almost push it. It is so close that one who stands up can almost push it. بالراحي with his palm. بالراحي. راحٌ means palm. راحةٌ is also palm. راحو is palm. And in my book, Europe Speaks Arabic, I have mentioned that the word, the English word racket, which is used in certain games like badminton, that is from the word rahatun, rahatun, palm, racket. Danin musifun fuwayqa al-ardi haydabuhu, haydabuhu, its fringes are very close to the earth, above the earth, yakadu. يدفعه من قام بالراحي. One who stands up can push it, almost push it. يكادو, it's not he doesn't push it, but he can almost push it. بالراحي with his palm. So that is an example of كادا being used for exaggeration. For example, you can say لا أكاد أراه. لا أكاد أراه. I can hardly see. He can see it, but hardly see. That means this is the element of exaggeration. I can hardly see it. I can hardly read this. It's so badly written that لا أكاد أقرأه. لا أكاد أقرأه. I can hardly read it. يكاد زيتها يضيء ولو لم تمسسه نار. نور على نور. So Nurun ala Nur. Hada Nurun ala Nur. The Mubtada is mahzuf here. Nurun ala Nur. Light upon light. Is a light piled upon another light. The meaning is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us intellect, which is also light, intellect to understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these heavens and this whole universe indicates that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created them. So there is light of intellect, and Qur'an is a light upon the light which has already been given to man. Nurun ala nur. Yahdi Allah li nurihi man yasha. Yahdi Allah li nurihi. Hada yahdi. The word hada can be used in three ways. One is, as in Surah Al-Fatiha, ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. Hada yahdi takes two objects. Ihdina, na is first object. As-sirata is second object. And the other form, the other way in which you can use it is as it is here. Allah yahdi Allahu li nurihi. Yahdi Allahu li nurihi man yasha. Allah guides to His light whom He wills. The third is using the word ila. We will see it later, a little later, inshallah. Yahdi Allahu li nurihi. So, using first usage is without harf jar. Ihdina sirata, two objects. The second is using lam with the second object. Yahdi Allahu li nurihi man yasha. Man is the first object. Man is fi mahalli nasb. And yasha'u is salat al-mawsool. And the a'id has been omitted because man yasha'uhu. Man yasha'uhu. As in the ayah, la a'budu ma ta'budun. La a'budu ma ta'budunahu. I do not worship what you worship. So ma la a'budu, I do not worship, ma is maf'ul bihi. And ta'budun is salat al-mawsool, and it should contain the a'id which returns to the ism al-mawsool. So ma ta'buduna hu. In the same way here, yahdi Allahu li nurihi man yasha'u hu. The a'id has been omitted. If the a'id is mansub, it can be omitted. Yahdi Allahu li nuri hada yahdi. Hada yahdi. It's a naqis verb. Hada yahdi. Wa yadribu Allahu al-amthala. Mathalun is a parable, is an example. Proverb. يَضْرِبُ اللَّهُ الْأَمْثَالَ ضَرَبَ, as you know, the primary meaning is to strike it. But there are other meanings also. So here ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ الْأَمْثَالَ means to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains or uses parables لِلنَّاسِ for the people to understand. وَيَضْرِبُ اللَّهُ الْأَمْثَالَ مَثَلٌ is plural. أَمْثَالَ like سَبَبٌ أَسْبَابٌ. Amthal, another meaning of the word mathal is a proverb. In Arabic, the word proverb is mathal. Mathalun jama'hu amthal. There is a very famous book. It's called Majma'ul Amthal. Majma'ul Amthal, a collection of proverbs. All the classical and also non-classical proverbs have been collected in this book. But it's by Al-Maidani. Al-Maidani, that is the name of the author. مجمع الأمثال للميداني ويضرب الله الأمثال للناس الله فاعل أمثال مفعول به للناس والله بكل شيء عليم الله is aware of everything والله مبتدا بكل شيء عليم خبر بكل شيء In this ayah we have كمشكات like as a niche ka is harf jar meaning like or as now this harf jar has a special feature it is used only with nouns it is not with pronouns there are many other vowels which are used both with the nouns as well as with the pronouns for example min You say أخذت الكتابة من بلال. You can also say أخذت الكتابة منه. In the same way على الكتاب على المكتب. You can also say الكتاب عليه. But كاف is used only with a noun. So for example you say بلال كعلي. بلال is like علي. بيتك كالقصر بيتك كالقصر your house is like a palace but you can't use it with a pronoun you can't say أنا كهو I am like him أنت كها you are like her you can't say like her. You can't say that we have to insert the word مثل between the harf jar kaf and the pronoun أنا كمثلك أنا كمثلك أنت كمثله أنت كمثله Now there are other حروف جر also منذ مذ حتى then واو القسم والله you can't use it with pronoun رب also cannot be used with a pronoun تاء as a حرف جر which is also a word harf meaning by in oath tallahi by Allah that cannot also be used with a pronoun now Ibn Malik in his Alfiyah refers to these harf huruf jar which cannot be used with pronouns. I will write that couplet for you to understand.
بالظاهر رخصص منذ منذ مذ وحتى والكاف والواو ورب والتاء
I'll read this line. بالظاهر خصص بالظاهر خصص منذ مذ وحتى والكاف والواو ورب والتاء بالظاهر الظاهر means a noun as against مضمر which is a pronoun بالظاهر خصص specify these words or use these words specifically with nouns. بالظاهر خصص خص يخص. This is Amr. بالظاهر خصص منذ since. مذ another word also meaning since. وحتى till. حتى مطلع الفجر حتى. والكافة الكافة this is the harf jar meaning like. Now الكافة is منصوب because it is the مفعول به of أخصص. منذ حتى all these are مبني nouns and that is why the علامة النصب does not appear in them, but here it appears. Wal-kafa wal-wawa. Al-waw, which is a harf jar, meaning by Allah, with oath, wal-qasam, wallahi. So we can't use it with a pronoun. Rubba meaning many a. And ta is also a preposition used for qasam. Tallahi, by Allah. So bi-dhahir khusus mundh wa hatta wal kafa wal wawa wa rubba wa ta. So these are the mundh hatta, three, kaf or four, waw, five, rubba, six, ta, seven. Now these seven are huruf jar, can be used only with nouns and cannot be used with pronouns. Now I'll give you a few ayat in which the word kaf, the preposition kaf, has been used in the Quran. For example, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَتَّخِذُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ أَنْدَادًا يُحِبُّونَهُمْ كَحُبِّ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. This is Surah Al-Baqarah 165. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَتَّخِذُ. And of mankind, of some who take for worship others besides Allah. Others besides Allah. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَتَّخِذُ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ أَنْدَادًا. They set them up as rivals to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَتَّخِذُ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ أَنْدَادًا يُحِبُّونَهُمْ. They love them. كَحُبِّ اللَّهِ, like the love of Allah. Or they love them with a love, with a love which is especially meant for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With a love which is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. يحبونهم كحب الله. So kaf, كحب الله, harf jar. والذين آمنوا أشد حبا لله. والذين آمنوا, as for those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are stauncher, أشد حبا لله. They believe in, those who believe are stauncher in the love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now there is one ayah. There's another ayah. وَلَيْسَ الذَّكَرُ كَالْأُنْثَى. وَلَيْسَ الذَّكَرُ كَالْأُنْثَى. The male is not like the female. Now this was said by the Imra'atu Imran, the wife of Imran, who is the mother of Maryam alayhi salam. So when she delivered the child, she had, before delivering the child, she had vowed to dedicate this child to the service of the temple. So she was disappointed when she delivered a female child, and she said, وَلَيْسَ الذَّكَرُ كَالْأُنْثَى. A male is not like a female. So وَلَيْسَ الذَّكَرُ كَالْأُنْثَى. Unsa, of course, is majroor, well, because it is a maqsoor noun ending in an alif.
the alamatul jar does not appear. وَلَيْسَ ذَكَرُ كَالْأُنْثَى.
Now here is, I would like to give you a poetic line, pre-Islamic, from pre-Islamic poetry, wherein the word kaf is used. And it also contains many words which are used in the Qur'an, so that is a good opportunity to learn some Qur'anic words through this poetic line. I will write the line first of all.
Ka natihin. Ka natihin. صخرة يوما ليوهنها كناطح صخرة يوما ليوهنها ولم يهنها ولم يهنها وأوها وأوها قرنه الوعيل The poet is Al-A'sha. I'll read the line. كَنَاطِحٍ صَخْرَةً يَوْمًا لِيُوهِنَهَا وَلَمْ يُهِنْهَا وَأَوْهَا قَرْنَهُ الْوَعِلُ Al-Wa'il, that is the main word here, important word. Wa'il is a mountain goat. Mountain goat with very large horns, and they keep on, you know, striking the rocks with their horns. So the poet says, "Kanatuhin sakhratan yawman liyuhina," like a mountain goat. Kanatuhin nataha yantahu, nataha yantahu. A group, bafataha yaftahu. Nataha means to strike with a horn. Kanatihin, kanatihin, like a mountain goat striking with his horns, sakhratan, sakhratan, a rock. And sakhratan here is maf'ul bihi mansub, and it is the maf'ul of ism al-fa'il natih. Kanatihin sakhratan. Yawman, on a day and one day, liyuhinaha. Now this is a Quranic word, awhana, wahana yahinu, wahana yahinu. Wahana yahinu is to be weak, or to become weak. Wahana yahinu. That is mujarrad, thulathi mujarrad. Now here is an ayah in the Quran in Surat Maryam. Zakariya alayhi salam says, قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي وَهَنَ الْأَرْضُ مِنِّي وَاشْتَعَلَ الرَّأْسُ شَيْبًا 19:4. قَالَ, he said, Zakariya alayhi salam, رَبِّي, my Lord, inni wahana al-azmu minni. Inni wahana al-azmu minni. Azm is bones. My bones have become weak. Inni wahana al-azmu. Azm is fa'il. Wahana al-azmu minni. In me. Or from me. My bones have become weak. وَاشْتَعَلَ الرَّأْسُ شَيْبًا وَاشْتَعَلَ شُعْلًا وَاشْتَعَلَ الرَّأْسُ شَيْبًا and my head is ablaze. وَاشْتَعَلَ الرَّأْسُ is burning, is ablaze. شَيْبًا with grey hair. With grey hair. So he is describing his old age, his state in the old age, that his bones are weak and his head is completely grey with old age. So there is wahana, wahana yahinu. There is another ayah, 3:139. وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْنَ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ وَلَا تَهِنُوا. Don't be weak. Do not be weak or do not become weak. وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا and do not be sad. وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْنَ You will indeed be superior to them. إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ if you are believers. وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَهَنَا يَهِنُوا and this is لَا نَاهِيَ وَلَا تَهِنُوا do not be weak, do not become weak. وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا and do not be sad. وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْنَ and you will be the superior. إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Now the اسْمُ الْفَاعِلِ وَهَنَا يَهِنُوا اسْمُ الْفَاعِلِ is وَاهِن and اسم التفضيل is أوهن, أوهن weakest or weaker. And this word is also used in the Quran in Surat Al-Ankabut 29:41. وَإِنَّ أَوْهَنَ الْبُيُوتِ أَوْهَن إِنَّ أَوْهَنَ الْبُيُوتِ أَوْهَنَ is mansub because it is اسم إِنَّ أَوْهَنَ الْبُيُوتِ Indeed, the weakest of the houses is labaytul ankabut, is the house of the spider. Ankabut is spider, and here you have lam lam al muzahlaqa. Inna awhan al buyuti labaytul ankabut. The weakest of houses indeed is the house of the spider. Then Bab 4 from Wahana is Auhana. Auhana is to weaken. Auhana Yuhinu. Yuhin Aswal Fa'il Muhinun. Muhinun, one who makes something weak. Now this word is also used in the Quran in 8:18. ذَلِكُمْ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ مُوهِنُ كَيْدِ الْكَافِرِينَ ذَلِكُمْ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ مُوهِنُ كَيْدِ الْكَافِرِينَ ذَلِكُمْ, that is the fact. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to weaken muhinu kaidil kafirin, the machinations of the unbelievers, the plots of the unbelievers, is going to weaken the plots of the unbelievers. Now that is the word here in the poetic line, kanatihin sakhratan yawman liyuhinaha awhana yuhinu liyuhinaha. He is striking the mountain goat is striking the rock in order to make it weak, to weaken it. Kanatihin sakhratan, the word sakhra, sakhrun meaning a rock is also used in the Quran in Surah Al-Fajr ayah number 9. وَثَمُودَ الَّذِينَ جَابُوا الصَّخْرَ بِالْوَادِ وَثَمُودَ الَّذِينَ جَابُوا الصَّخْرَ بِالْوَادِ and Thamud, the tribe of Thamud, الَّذِينَ هُو جَابُوا الصَّخْرَ, cut off the rocks bilwadi in the valley to build houses. They used to cut off very strong and very large rocks. وثمود الذين جابوا is to cut, to hew. وثمود الذين جابوا الصخرة بالواد. So this line, alhamdulillah, has got many words. كناطهن صخرة يوما ليوهنها. The goat, mountain goat, is striking the rock. ليوهنها, to make it weak, to weaken it. Walam yuhinha, ahana yuhinha, again bab 4, walam yuhinha, but he did not weaken it, he could not weaken it. Wa auha qarnahul wa'ilu, but what happened to it? Wa auha, he weakened. This is another word, waha yahi. This is also a Quranic word. Waha yahi. To become weak, to become feeble, to fall apart. Now this word is used in the Quran in the Ism al-Fa'il in Surat al-Haq, وَانْشَقَّتِ السَّمَاءُ وَهِيَ يَوْمَئِذٍ وَاهِيَةٌ وَهِيَ يَوْمَئِذٍ وَاهِيَةٌ وَانْشَقَّتِ السَّمَاءُ, and the heaven will split asunder. انْشَقَّ, the heaven will split asunder. فَهِيَ يَوْمَئِذٍ, and it will become on that day, وَاهِيَة, weak and falling apart. وَانْشَقَّتِ السَّمَاءُ فَهِيَ يَوْمَئِذٍ وَاهِيَةٌ. Those who know Urdu know this word is used in Urdu very extensively. Wahiyat, you say the wahiyat means nonsense. So it is a plural of wahiyah, that is very weak talk, talk which doesn't have any sense. وَانْشَقَّتِ السَّمَاءُ فَهِيَ يَوْمَئِذٍ وَاهِيَةٌ. Now we'll go back to this line. Yes, waha yahi. Bab 4, afala is awha. To weaken, to make something weak. Auha yuhi. So he says, walam yuhinha wa auha qarnahul wa'ilu. Qarn is maful bihi before the fa'il. Wa auha wa'ilu qarnahu. The mountain goat weakened its own horn. Qarn is horn, qurun is the plural. وَأَوْهَا قَرْنَهُ الْوَعِيلُ. I'll read again. كَنَاطِحٍ صَخْرَةً يَوْمًا لِيُوهِنَهَا. Like the mountain goat which strikes the rock. لِيُوهِنَهَا, to make it weak. وَلَمْ يُهِنْهَا, but he could not weaken it. وَأَوْهَا قَرْنَهُ الْوَعِلُ, but the mountain goat weakened its own horn. So there are many Quranic words in this line. And then the word, as I told you before, نَطَحَ, كَنَاطِحٍ, ناطح, as one who strikes with his horn. It is bab fa'ala yaf'alu, like fataha yaftah, nataha yantahu. Nataha yantahu is to strike with a horn. And natih ism al-fa'il. We have a word natihatun, natihatun. This is a Quranic word. Natihatun. It's like qatilun, qatilun, one who has been killed. It has got the meaning of the ism al-maf'ul. Jarihun, one who has been wounded. So natihun or natihatun, an animal which has been gored to death with the horns by another animal. So in Surat Al-Ma'idah 5:3, there is a ayah. The ayah speaks of things which are forbidden, whose eating is forbidden. حُرِّمَتْ عَلَيْكُمْ الْمَيْتَةُ, forbidden to you or are the dead. حُرِّمَتْ عَلَيْكُمْ الْمَيْتَةُ وَالدَّمُ, and blood. وَلَحْمُ الْخِنْزِيرِ, and the flesh of swine flesh. So there is a long list of words. One of them is النَّتِيحَةُ, an animal which has been gored to death with the horns of another animal. النَّتِيحَةُ. So we have النَّتِيحَة, we have صَخْرَة, صَخْرٌ in the Quran, and we have got أَوْهَنَ يُوهِنُ, and أَوْهَى. أَوْهَى we don't know in the Quran, but we have got وَهَى, اسم الفاعل, وَيَوَى يَوْمَ إِذٍ وَاهِيَة. Now, that's Al-A'sha, the poet, his name of the poet is Al-A'sha. Al-A'sha literally means one who can't see at night. Al-A'sha, a man who cannot see at night. And the feminine is Ashwa'u. Imra'atun Ashwa'u. Mamnun Man As-Sarf, A'sha is also Mamnun Man As-Sarf, Ashwa'u. It is also used for a she camel who cannot see at night, and when she walks, she puts her feet wherever she likes or wherever the feet go. So the word Ashwa'i. Ashwa'iyun is used for random, without any order, without any plan. Ashwa'i. Now the next ayah, fi buyutin adhina Allahu an turfa'a wa yudhkara fiha ismu. Fi buyutin, in houses. Now the ayah starts with a shibu jumla, fi buyutin, in houses. Adhin Allahu an turfa'a, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has permitted to be raised, to be built. An turfa'a, adhin Allah, adhina ya'adhanu, adhina ya'adhanu, it is sami'a yasma'u bab, ia group. أذن الله أن ترفع, رفع يرفع, like فتح يفتح, رفع يرفع, to raise, to build high. في بيوت أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه, and that his name should be praised therein, mentioned therein. يذكر فيها اسمه. يُسَبِّحُ فِيهَا بِالْغُدُوِّ وَالْعَصَالِ رِجَالٌ. Now these houses which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has permitted to be raised, and therein his name to be mentioned, but this is this refers to the mosques. فِي بُيُوتٍ أَذِنَ اللَّهُ أَن تُرُفْعَ وَيُذْكَرَ فِيهَا اسْمُهُ. Now, fi buyutin, harf jar, and the mutaallaq of this harf jar is yusabbihu fiha. Some mufassirin think that fi buyutin, the mutaallaq is Allahu Nur al-Misbahu fi zujaja, as zujajatu
This lamp is the houses which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has permitted to be raised, but that doesn't have as much meaning as we say يُسَبِّحُ فِيهَا بِالْغُدُوِّ وَالْعَصَارِ رِجَالٌ. People, you know, praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, commemorate his praise in houses which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has permitted to be raised. So in these houses there is mention of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is the mutaallaq of fi here is yusabbihu, which is in the same ayah. Of course the harf jar fi is repeated here. Fi buyutin adhinallahu in turfa'a wa yudhkara fiha ismuhu yusabbihu lahu fiha. Again, for emphasis, it has been repeated. Fi buyutin adhinallahu an turfa'a wa yudhkara fiha ismuhu. Turfa'a wa yudhkara fiha ismuhu. Fiha ismuhu. Ismuhu is naib fa'il of yudhkar. Wa yudhkaru ismuhu fiha. يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ فِيهَا بِالْغُدُوِّ. غُدُوِّ is morning. From the time of morning prayer. بِالْغُدُوِّ وَالْآصَال. آصَال is the plural of أَصِيل. أَصِيل is evening. And أَصَال is the plural of أَصِيل. يُصَبِّحُ فِيهَا بِالْغُدُوِّ وَالْآصَالِ. Now in the word غَدَات, غَدَاءٌ, غَدَاءٌ in the Qur'an in Surat Al-Kahf it is used. آتِنَا غَدَاءَنَا لَقَدْ لَقِينَا مِنْ سَفَرِنَا هَذَا نَصَبًا. آتِنَا غَدَاءَنَا. Musa alayhi salam says to his companion, Atina fatahu, atina ghadaana, give us our breakfast. Now in modern Arabic, the word ghada is used for lunch. But as eating habits have changed, but in classical Arabic, ghada refers to the food that is consumed at the time of ghuduv, in the morning. So we must be very careful when we understand try to understand the texts of the Quran. There are certain words which have changed during the ages. In modern Arabic, they have a different meaning. For example, the word jayb, وَأَدْخِلْ يَدَكَ فِي جَيْبِكَ in the Quran. Musa alayhi salam is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands Musa alayhi salam saying, وَأَدْخِلْ يَدَكَ فِي جَيْبِكَ. وَجَيْب in classical Arabic means the bosom opening of a shirt. The bosom opening of a shirt. So it's not pocket. In modern Arabic it means pocket. But in classical Arabic it means the opening of the shirt in the region of the chest. وَأَدْخِلْ يَدَكَ فِي جَيْبِكَ. Also another word like سَيَّارَ. In Surat Yusuf we have Sayyaratun. Sayyaratun means a group of people traveling together. It's a caravan. It's not like it's not a car as it is in modern Arabic. Another word is qariyatun. Qariya in classical Arabic means a township. A town or a township, and not a village as it is now in modern Arabic. Ummul Qura means a metropolis. Metropolis. The word metropolis, Greek word, exactly means what Ummul Qura means, because metropolis means mother of cities. Meter in Latin, Greek means mother, polis is city. Metropolis, the mother of cities. It is the same meaning which the word Ummul Qura has. Ummul Qura, Ummul's mother, and Qura is a plural of Qariya, which means a township, a town. It doesn't mean village as in modern Arabic. So when we understand, try to understand the text of the Quran, We should be very careful. We do not ascribe modern meaning to the words which have their classical meaning in the Quran. So al-ghudu, ghadatun, I wanted to say al-ghada. Al-ghada in modern Arabic means lunch, but in Quranic Arabic it means breakfast, early morning food. في بيوت أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه يسبح له فيها له لله سبحانه وتعالى بالغدو والآصال رجال. Now رجال is the فاعل of يسبح. يسبح له فيها بالغدو والآصال رجال من لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع. لا تلهيهم تجارة. تجارة is فاعل of تلهي. الها يلهي is verb 4. لها يلهو to be diverted. To be diverted, not to be concentrate on his work. So the verb 4 is الها. الها يلهي. الهاكم التكاثر. So for example you say الهتني مباراة كرة القدم عن دراستي. الهتني feminine. الهتني مباراة. مباراة is match. الهتني مباراة كرة القدم soccer match diverted me from my studies. الهتني مباراة كرة القدم عن دراستي. سؤالها لا تلهيهم تجارة من who remember Allah سبحانه وتعالى the men who praise Allah سبحانه وتعالى commemorate his praise in these mosques. لا تلهيهم تجارة business. تجارة business. ولا بيع nor sale. You know, tijara, the word tijara or business is a complex series of activities. It's not one activity, it is a series of activities. The most important activity in this series is selling, sale. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, first of all, tijara, and then he specifically mentions bay'a. Ba'a yabi'u, masdar is bay'a. Rijalun la tulhihim tijaratun wala bay'un. Now please note that the word tijara, we have this alif khanjariya, alif al-khanjariya, small alif. Then tijaratun, I'll write on the blackboard, tijaratun, it's written like this. So the alif, Qanjari alif, is written after jim. So you have to re-pronounce the jim as well as the alif, as I told you before, because it is written after the jim. It's not placed right on top of the jim. Rijalun la tulhihim alha yulhi la tulhihim tijaratun wala bay'un, business and sale activities do not divert them from remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا بَيُّ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ from the remembrance of Allah. وَإِقَامِ الصَّلَاةِ and from establishing prayer. وَإِيْتَاءِ الزَّكَاةِ and pay in the payment of zakah. Now the word إِقَامِ الصَّلَاةِ أَقَامَ يُقِيمُ is form 4. أقام يقيم and the مصدر is إقامة with a تاء مربوطة at the end, just like أجاب يجيب to reply. أجاب يجيب إجابة. In the same way أقام يقيم إقامة. But when this word happens to be the مضاف, happens to be a مضاف, the تاء may be omitted. as it is here, wa iqami salat, not iqamati salat. You can say also iqamati salat, but it's better to say wa iqami salati, the dropping of the ta marbuta, wa iqami salati. Now note that the word salah, the al-alif al-khanjariya is placed right on top of the waw. So you have to pronounce only the alif, not the waw. وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة. Also in zakah, the khanjariya alif is placed right on top of the waw. إيتاء is مصدر of آتا يؤتي. آتا يؤتي. Bab 4. آتا يؤتي إيتاء. إيتاء. Actually it was إيتاء. The first article is Hamza. And this extra alif e i'ta'un. But as we know that if the hamza is sakin, sakin hamza comes after another hamza, which is if it is maftuha, it becomes alif. For example, we say ta'kulu, you eat, na'kulu, we eat, but a'kulu, I eat. It's not a'kulu. Originally it is a'kulu, it becomes a'kulu. Ta'khudhu, you take. Na'khudhu, we take. Ya'khudhu, he takes. But a'khudhu, for a'khudhu, it becomes a'khudhu. If it is the first hamza, if it has dhamma, the second hamza becomes waw. Athalan, anta tu'minu, you believe. Huwa yu'minu, he believes. Nu'minu, we believe. But u'minu, I believe, is u'minu, for u'minu. In the same way, iman. Iman is i'man. It's on the measure of if'al. So i'man, the first radical is hamza, and this extra alif. So it becomes i'man, becomes iman. So ita is actually ata, yu'ti, ita becomes ita. Ita is zakah, payment of zakah. يَخَافُونَ يَوْمًا تَتَقَلَّبُ فِيهِ الْقُلُوبُ وَالْأَبْصَارِ. These people who are engaged in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the mosques and in prayer, establishing a salah and paying zakah and business and sale activities, do not divert them from these activities. They are afraid of yakhafuna, they fear yawman. Yawman here is maful bihi. Yakhafuna, what do they fear? They fear a day. Tataqallabu fihi al-qulub wal-absaq. A day in which the word yawman is nakira, maful bihi. And the sentence tataqallabu fihi al-qulub wal-absaq, jumla fa'liya, this is na'at of yawman. Yawman tataqallabu, wherein hearts and sight or eyesight will be overturned. Tataqallabu, taqallaba, yataqallabu is bab tafa'ala. Tataqallabu fihi, fihi the harafers to yawman. Tataqallabu fihi al-qulubu wal-absar. Yawman, for example, kam labithta, labithtu yawman, or dhahabtu ila makkata wa baqitu fiha yawman. I went to Mecca and stayed there for a day. It is maful fihi, it is maful fihi, dharf. Baqitu fihi yawman. But akhafu yawman, I am afraid of a day. Here it is maful bihi. Now, liyajziyahumullahu أحسن ما عملوا ويزيدهم من فضله والله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب. Now this is lam, lam al-ta'lil. As you know, lam al-ta'lil, there is an which can be omitted or which can be mentioned. لأن يجزيهم, or we can say ليجزيهم. دخلت الحمام لي أتوضأ, or you can also say لأن يتوضأ. So the original form is لِأَنْ يَتَوَضَّأَ, but can you omit an and say لِأَتَوَضَّأَ. لِيَجْزِيَهُمْ جَزَى يَجْزِي جَزَى يَجْزِي لِيَجْزِيَهُمُ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنَ مَا عَمِلُوا, so that Allah may recompense them for the best of what they did. أَحْسَنَ مَا عَمِلُوا وَيَزِيدَهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ زَادَ يَزِيدُ, to increase, زَادَ يَزِيدُ زِيَادَةً. It also takes two objects. Rabbi zidni ilma, zidni ilma, increase me in knowledge. Wa yazidahum min fadlih, so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may recompense them for the best of what they did. Wa yazidahum min fadlih, and give them more, increase them in their reward, min fadli, out of his bounty, of his grace. Wallahu yarzuqu man yasha'u bighayri hisab. Wallahu yarzuqu, it is Allah who provides them with what he yarzuqu man yasha'u, it is Allah who provides whomever he wills. بِغَيْرِ حِسَاب, without measure. وَاللَّهُ يَرْزُقُ مَنْ, جُمْلَ اسْمِيَة, it is جُمْلَ اسْمِيَة, in جُمْلَ اسْمِيَة it is, for example, if we say بِلَالٌ سَافَرَ بِلَالٌ, this is جُمْلَ فَعْلِيَة, سَافَرَ بِلَالٌ. The question is here whether he has already traveled or not. So when I say Safara Bilalun, means Bilal has traveled. But if we say Bilalun Safara, the question is whether it was Bilal who traveled or his brother or his son. So here we say Bilalun Safara, it is Bilal who traveled. The emphasis is on the person, while in Safara Bilalun, the emphasis is on the action. So Wallahu yarzuqu min yasha'u, it is Allah who provides. Wallahu yarzuqu min yasha'u, razaqa yarzuqu. Raziqun is ismul fa'il, and razzaqun is mubalaghat ismul fa'il. Wallahu yarzuqu, razaqa yarzuqu, bab fa'ala yaf'ulu. نصر ينصر من يشاء, من is مفعول به في محل نصب, يشاء is صلة الموصول, and as I mentioned before the عائد is omitted. من يشاءه, من يشاءه, بغير حساب. Now the word حساب is مصدر of حسب يحسب, حسب يحسب, باب نصر ينصر, باب نصر ينصر, حسب يحسب is to calculate. بغير حساب, without calculation, that is without measure, without calculating how much you deserve. He just gives you what he wills, how much he wills. وَاللَّهُ يَرْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. You will see in the next ayah, حِسَاب is used twice with two different meanings. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَعْمَالُهُمْ كسراب بقيعة يحسبه الظمآن ماء حتى إذا جاءه لم يجده شيئا ووجد الله عنده وفاه حسابه والله سريع الحساب. Now in this ayah, in the previous ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the recompense reward of the believers. And here in this ayah, he refers to the, he mentions the reward, the punishment of the unbelievers. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَالَّذِينَ مُبْتَدَى كَفَرُوا is Salatul Mawsool, and the waw in kafaru, that is the ayat, it refers to al-ladhina. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَعْمَالُهُمْ. Now al-ladhina is mubtada, أَعْمَالُهُمْ is jumla, is its khabar. أَعْمَالُهُمْ كَسَرَابٍ. Their deeds are like mirage. أَعْمَالُهُمْ كَسَرَابٍ. Their actions are their deeds all like mirage. You know, mirage is what a man sees in the desert, as if there is water, and actually it is no water, but it appears to be water. Sarab. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَعْمَالُهُمْ كَسَرَابٍ. This kaf, kaf is harf jar, and it means like, as I've seen kamishkatin, the first ayah, we said, مَثَلُهُ مَثَلُ نُورِهِ كَمِشْكَاتٍ كَسَرَابٍ بِقِيعَةٍ. قِيعَة is a plain in a desert. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَعْمَالُهُمْ كَسَرَابٍ بِقِيعَةٍ. الْبَاهِيَة is in the sense of fee. We have learnt in the Durus al-Lughah al-Arabiyya. For example, we say, أَكُلُ بِالْمِلْعَقَةِ. أَكُلُ بِالْمِلْعَقَةِ. I eat with a spoon. أَكُلُ بِالْمِلْعَقَةِ. لَا تَكْتُبْ بِالْقَلَمِ الْأَحْمَرِ. Don't write with a red pen. لَا تَكْتُبْ بِالْقَلَمِ الْأَحْمَرِ. سَافَرْتُ إِلَى مَكَّةَ بِالسَّيَّارَةِ. I traveled to Mecca in a car. But here, B is in the sense of fee, in. As in the ayah, وَلَقَدْ نَصَرَكُمُ اللَّهُ بِبَدْرٍ. وَلَقَدْ نَصَرَكُمُ اللَّهُ بِبَدْرٍ. We also say, for example, أَسْكُنُوا بِالْمَدِينَةِ الْمُنَوَّرَةِ. أَسْكُنُوا بِالْمَدِينَةِ الْمُنَوَّرَةِ. I live in Medina. So B is also used in the sense of fee. كَبِقِيعَةٍ, in a plain. يَحْسَبُهُ الظَّمْآنُ مَاءً. حَسِبَ يَحْسَبُ. حَسِبَ يَحْسَبُ. حَسِبَ يَحْسَبُ takes two objects. As here, يَحْسَبُهُ الظَّمْآنُ مَاءً. حَسِبَ يَحْسَبُ is in bab سَمِعَ يَسْمَعُ. But it is also used with kasra in the madi and kasra in the mudari, second radical. حَسِبَ يَحْسِبُ. It is used only in grammatical examples, but the word, the bab in which it is used mostly is حَسِبَ يَحْسَبُ. كَسَرَابٍ بِقِيَعَةٍ يَحْسَبُهُ الظَّمْآنُ مَاءً. So here the first maf'ul is يَحْسَبُهُ. The second is مَاءً. There are two objects. For example, you say حَسِبْتُ بِلَالًا عَالِمًا. I thought Bilal to be a scholar. حَسِبْتُ بِلَالًا عَالِمًا. ظَمْآن. Wam'an is thirsty. The verb is Wami'a yadma'u. Wami'a yadma'u in bab sami'a yasma'u.
Dhamia, Dhamaun, Dhamaun, first. Dhamanu, Dhamanu, Alif Noon. And it is Mamnu Man Sarb. Dhamanu, thirsty. And its feminine is Dhama. هذا الرجل ضمآن هذه المرأة ضمآ. And the plural of both the masculine as well as the feminine is ضماء ضماء. هؤلاء الرجال ضماء وهؤلاء النساء ضماء. It's the same for masculine as well as feminine. يحسبه الضمآن. Another word is atshanu, that we have learnt. Yahsabuhu, the pronoun hu refers to sarab, which is mentioned before this. Yahsabu kasarabin biqi'atin yahsabuhu al-dhamanu, which a thirsty man thinks to be water. Ma'an. يحسبه الظمآن ماء حتى إذا جاءه لم يجده شيئا till حتى إذا جاءه if he goes there لم يجده شيئا he did not find it anything لم يجده الها هي refers to سراب which he, لم يجده شيئا he did not find it or he doesn't find it anything. He find therein nothing. Now here, the word wajada has got two usages. One is to find a thing after it is lost. Say, we say, Dha'a kitabi, my book was lost, Dha'a kitabi, thumma wajadtuhu. ثم وجدته بعد يومين. I found it after 2 days. So here, وجد takes only one object. وجدته بعد يومين. I found it after 2 days. ضاعت ساعتي. My watch was lost. ثم وجدتها. ثم وجدتها في سيارتي. I found it in my car. Another meaning is to find a thing, something else. It is also in English we use the same. We say, I found the door open. وَجَدْتُ الْبَابَ مَفْتُوحًا. I found the door open. عندما ذهبت إلى البيت وجدت الباب مفتوحًا. When I went home, I found the door open. Just like in English we also have in Arabic. وَجَدْتُ الطَّعَامَ لَذِيذًا. I found the food tasty. وَجَدْتُ الطَّعَامَ. طَعَامَ is مَفْعُولَ أَوَّلْ. لَذِيذًا is مَفْعُولَ ثَانِي. These two مَفْعُولَ أَوَّلْ مَفْعُولَ ثَانِي, they are actually مُبْتَدَعَ خَبَرْ. الطَّعَامُ لَذِيذٌ. وَجَدْتُ الطَّعَامَ لَذِيذًا. وَجَدَ يَجِدُ. المضارع is وَجَدَ يَجِدُ. In both cases, in both usages, وَجَدَ يَجِدُ. لَمْ يَجِدْهُ حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَهُ لَمْ يَجِدْهُ شَيْئًا. He did not find it, find mirage, شَيْئًا. وَجَدَهُ لَمْ يَجِدْهُ شَيْئًا. مَا أَكَلْتُ شَيْئًا. I ate nothing. مَا كَتَبْتُ شَيْئًا. I wrote nothing. مَا رَأَيْتُ شَيْئًا. I saw nothing. إذا جاء لم يجده شيئا ووجد الله عنده. But he found Allah سبحانه وتعالى therein. وجد الله عنده. عنده الها. Here ha refers to also sarab again. He found at the place of mirage, as what he thought was water. He found, did not find any water there, but he found Allah سبحانه وتعالى. ووجد الله عنده فَوَفَّاهُ حِسَابَهُ فَوَفَّاهُ حِسَابَهُ. And he paid him his wages in full. He paid him his wages, that is, he punished him.
فَوَفَّاهُ حِسَابَهُ وَاللَّهُ سَرِيعُ الْحِسَابِ Allah is quick in reckoning. Now, I want to explain to you this word, حِسَاب. حَسَبَ يَحْسُبُ As I told you before, حَسَبَ يَحْسُبُ Not حَسَبَ يَحْسِبُ is different. Which takes two objects in the sense of to consider. But حَسَبَ يَحْسُبُ is to calculate. Hisab, you know, mathematics is from this word, calculation and mathematics, hisab.